Tom has given us a number of photographs and videos recorded inside Parliament House of men engaged in blatant sex acts. They proudly film themselves and share the videos. And we warn you that the images are shocking. Some are so bad, we can't show you them at all. And what we can, we've taken great care to blur or distort the images. But what's happening is unmistakable. This man is sitting at a desk, exposing himself. You can't see it, but he's staring straight at the camera. That's a copy of the Parliament House rulebook beside him. Here a man arrogantly points to the desk of a female Liberal MP, then performs a solo sex act on it. It's far too explicit to show or even describe. But Tom tells us it's common.
The fact that it's a female MP only adds to the disgrace that it is.
It all happened in that building just behind you.
Yeah, it did, all of it.
It's almost impossible to believe.
It's surprising, and I think a lot of people will be just stunned.
And it doesn't stop there. This group of coalition staffers also routinely swap explicit photos of themselves.
I've received so many that I've just become immune to it.
PVO joins us now from Canberra this morning. The Prime Minister has responded. PVO, what's he had to say?
Look, he has. He's labelled what he saw on that 10 News First report as disgusting and not good enough. And he's delayed his party room meeting by an hour this morning. There is speculation that he'll look to address this publicly in a statement, a very unusual and strong statement that was released by his office last night. He made it clear that he will have more to say on this in due course this week. So we'll find out whether that's today. You saw there the action that one of the staffers in question has already been sacked. There are other staffers. I've seen the images, I've seen the videos. I know who the other staffers are. They continue to be employed in the building, but for legal reasons, we can't refer to them. The government wants to get to the bottom of this. When you talk to them, I spoke to Senator Simon Birmingham about this earlier. He's got responsibility as finance minister for this sphere, but it's whether people feel confident in coming forward. He wants the whistleblower, for example, to come forward, but then his anonymity is potentially exposed. Will they indeed interview the sacked staffer? Because my understanding is that he knows quite a bit about some of these other allegations, which include the issue of sex workers being let in the building.
Yeah, into that prayer room or meditation room within Parliament House, I had read online that this had been a fairly open secret within the walls of Parliament House, PVO, that people, I mean, even your own whistleblower admitted to having sex inside this prayer room.
Yeah, look, I mean, away from the very serious side of this, this has been discussed in a more jocular way a few years ago by Sam Dastyari as being an open secret. It was news to me. I mean, obviously, anyone in this building would say that now, wouldn't they? I didn't even know where it was, and I've never actually been there myself. But it's accessed via the mural hall, I'm now led to believe. Something that I can tell you, tomorrow it's going to be used for a different purpose to the allegations. A notice went out to House and Senate members saying that at 7:30 a.m. tomorrow morning there will actually be a prayer in the prayer room, the meditation room, on the parable of Jesus. So a little bit different to some of the activities that have been discussed by the whistleblower.
All right, sounds like you've got a busy day ahead, PVO. Thanks so much for joining us this morning.
Thanks, guys.